It's a city that's got a lot of grit. It's got a lot of soul. It's got a lot of texture to it.
Memphis, even with 1 million people, is still a small town at its core. It was late 2008. The economy was really taking a nosedive at that time. We said, well, let's think about what will be the niche. Maybe you need more retail. And so we just took out around the city to think about where would be a good place to locate. When I walked in, I immediately called Tom and said, I found our home. We were the first retail to come to Broad Avenue. The community of Binghamton was a very active community up until about 1950, early 1960s. But then this thing called Interstate 40 was about to come through.
It really just split that community. It isolated the residential areas from the commercial areas. Broad Avenue corridor was pretty much wiped out.
Once I got here, it's like, well, how do we make the gallery better? And then we saw that needed to be a neighborhood. We thought, you know, if we could show people what could happen, it would help more people to come locate here and think about it. For 2 days, we staged what we thought Broad Avenue could be.
You're filling all of these vacant storefronts. You're bringing so much activity to that street for a day. There was momentum already on Broad, but it just kicked it over the top.
We had hoped for 5,000 to come and 15,000 showed up. And it was truly just a tipping point because then you had so many people coming back to Broad Avenue. And it also allowed us to really introduce what bike lanes could be. Being a retail owner, anytime someone discusses that they might bring more traffic by your front door, you immediately just say yes.
The Hamp Line is an innovative two-way cycle track that's completely separated from traffic by planted medians, rain gardens. The last link in connecting a 4,500-acre regional park to one of Memphis's premier parks. You know, we've gone in 40 years from almost having an interstate go through this park to having an interstate for bicycles and pedestrians.
We said, you know what, this could be a very powerful, engaging project for the public. And we had heard about crowdfunding and IOBI. And so we thought, you know, maybe this is a way to really engage the community.
That was one of the coolest stories, I thought. You know, it's like, has anybody ever really fundraised this much from citizens to actually pay for public infrastructure?
You feel like you're part of that project. You're more likely to go out and use it and bike on it. And IOBI, I think, did all those things with the Hamp Line and Memphis.
It's really giving people ownership of how their charitable donations are being spent and getting them involved in actually making those projects come to fruition.
Broad Avenue has really emerged as this national example for how a neighborhood can, in essence, bootstrap its own redevelopment.
I like being able to see all those faces, young and old, and black and brown and white, and different economic groups, and we're all coming together as one. To me, that is what Memphis is all about. And just what makes the place more livable and enjoyable.